looking.
All right, the major story here is we have two conflicts with our next guest. Like Jessica, he hails originally from Ohio, but unlike Jessica, he is fearless and as tough
true.
As can be. And I've always wanted to have a nickname. Coyote Peterson, is your real name Coyote?
It's a nickname I've had since I was 8 years old.
All right.
Yeah.
Anyway, we're glad to have you here. People who know your stuff revere it. Are you really this brave or dumb or what?
Well, yeah. I like to say brave.
Okay.
You know, the dumb comes with a lot of education for a lot of people that watch me be stung or bitten by a lot of these creatures, which honestly only makes up about 10% of our content, but it does draw people into the episodes that are more focused on conservation and education stuff. Now, all the stings do come with education because we have to learn from the things that coyote
now,
does.
Now, parents going, no, my child doesn't have to learn by getting stung and touching things. Were your parents that way? As a kid, were you trying this kind of stuff?
Not so much getting stung intentionally or bitten. The goal was to always not be bitten or stung.
Right.
But believe it or not, it's a lot of the parents watching that are the ones that allow the kids to watch. And they love teaching their kids in this sort of a fashion.
So what was your biggest surprise thinking, oh, this won't hurt, but then all of a sudden, wow, this one really dropped?
Probably the very first time we did one of these, which was with a little ant called a harvester ant, and being like, oh, you know, it can't be that bad.
It's an
They're just little ants. Yeah. And there was like four of them around the mound. I put my hands down there before you know it. There's 60 of them crawling all over me.
Oh.
Ants in my pants. I mean, there's nothing worse than stinging ants in your pants.
Oh. Wow. We're going to look at a clip involving tarantula in just a second. But this Brave Wilderness brand couldn't be bigger or more prominent, particularly online. How'd you come up with the whole thing?
Well, I was inspired by obviously people that came before me, Jeff Corwin, Jack Hanna, of course, Steve Irwin. And, you know, when Steve sadly passed away, we saw this void in people bringing animals to the next generation. We said, well, we've got to do this, and being able to do it in the digital age where we have creative control of the content that we're making and being able to bring it to the world through YouTube, where we're really reaching that younger demographic, for us was the goal. But of course, parents are enjoying it as well. And it's sort of a co-viewing opportunity where parents and their kids can sit down and learn about all these animals and then, of course, enjoy me getting bitten and stung from time to time.
Well, who doesn't enjoy that? Watch this with the tarantula look.
Ah! Oh my gosh! Oh! Oh! I can't move my arm! That is the most intense pain I've ever felt! I don't think I can talk!
A tarantula
hawk?
Tarantula hawk.
What is that?
Well, it's actually a type of spider wasp. They kill tarantulas. That's what they do. They go around, they find tarantulas, kill them, and then lay an egg inside of the spider. That egg, like a little alien, hatches inside, eats its internals, and then crawls out,
man.
And you've got a wasp.
Yeah. Do we have those here?
You do. They're a southwestern species, so it's not something you need to worry about, though. They're pollinators. They aren't out there ever looking to sting or interact with humans, but if you are stung by one, it's going to be a very bad day.
And here's the surprise for all of you.
What?
Coyote's brought some things with him today.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
It's a book.
Oh, okay.
That's for reading.
You know what? That was pretty good.
I'm proud of myself.
There is the book there. But your own personal interest, what, you saw a bug and thought that was interesting, or?
For me, it all began with the common snapping turtle, which is this large reptilian predator that we do have in Ohio. And for me, that was sort of my crocodile. Mm. And as a kid, I would go off into the woods and into the swamps looking for these giant turtles. And it started my fascination with everything that was animals. And then as we started developing the shows, you know, it became, well, turtles are cute, but can you catch something bigger? And that turned into alligators. And then it turned into really getting these bizarre creatures up close for the cameras. It's the insects and the weird, strange sea creatures that people have never seen that they're certainly fascinated by, that we bring them on the internet.
Wow, and are there particular places, because with the outfit,
right,
where do you like to, if my kids want to go camping, where should I take them?
Any one of your local, state, or national parks, as long as you're following the right rules and regulations, is a wonderful place for families to explore. I mean, obviously, where we film, we are off the beaten path on wildlife reserves and stuff like that, but there's so many incredible wild places, not only here in California, but all across the United States, for us to actually step away from our devices and get outside and enjoy nature.
Well said. Coyote Peterson's new book, Brave Wilderness, the channel is on YouTube. And you can pick up a copy of the book, Brave Adventures, available in stores nationwide, Amazon.com as well. Coyote, that's the greatest name ever.
Yeah.
Nice to meet you.
Thank you so much for having me, guys.
Thank you.
Coyote.
Coming up.